Did you know that integration is a key tenet of SAP's strategy and mission? SAP helps customers achieve seamless business processes through our integrated applications and a modern cloud-based integration solution running on SAP Business Technology Platform. Want to know more? Join us virtually or in person at this year's Tech Ed. There, you'll hear an update to SAP's application integration strategy, learn about new capabilities that strengthen integrations across our application portfolio, roadmap and innovations for SAP Integration Suite. Want to see integration in action? Join workshops for building composable integration, setting up CI/CD pipelines for Integration Suite, or participate in person and build event-driven integrations using Apache Kafka and SAP Integration Suite. But check out the session catalog for more information. No matter where you are on your learning journey, you'll find sessions on the integration topic that will broaden your knowledge and help you succeed with SAP solutions. Register today, clear your calendar, and see you in November.
We are wrapping up another week of Devtoberfest 2022 here at SAP and rolling right into the third week of the four-week event. Monday is all about a BOP. We had sessions on Exorcism, Legacy Code, and Wrap on S/4HANA Cloud with upcoming sessions on the history of a BOP and troubleshooting Wrap-based Fiori applications. Tuesday is UI Day, with this week discussing SAP Fiori application creation with open source tools and SAP Business Technology Platform destinations with SAP Fiori tools. Next week, we will have a session from the authors of the Clean SAP UI 5 book and a session from the creator of the VDI 5 testing tool on testing. Data and Analytics is on Wednesday and had sessions on integration of two SAP Cloud products and enhancing functionality with scripting. There was also a special session with Jorgen Mueller and past Devtoberfest winners, so be sure to check that out. Next week for Data and Analytics, we will have two sessions on SAP Data Warehouse Cloud. Our most session-heavy day is Thursday, with low-code, no-code having six AppGyver-based sessions this week, with five process automation-based sessions next week. Friday is fun day, but also cloud-native development day. We had a session on HANA Cloud, as well as a part one of a session on SAP BTP, Chemo Runtime Operations. The fun event this week was a trivia quiz containing questions all about SAP and its history. Coming up, we have part two of the SAP BTP Chemo Runtime Operation session with another session on containerization. And for our Fun of Friday event, it's all about gaming next week. We have an all-day game event with developer advocates joining throughout the day, along with two tournament-style gaming sessions using a game made by our very own developer advocate, Nico. All this has been summarized in the week three blog post, so be sure to check that out. In other news, the first stable release of UI5 Web Components for React, version 1.0.1, was released late last week. This version includes a few breaking changes and a complete overhaul of the filter bar component. Be sure to check the release notes linked below for more info. With version 1 plus, there will be no more breaking changes from minor version to minor version, so the library will be easier to update and semantic versioning will work much better as well. I hope to see y'all joining us for week 3 of Devtoberfest 2022, and happy coding!
It's that time again. There's a new release of the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model Framework for September 2022. And as usual, this release brings lots of great content. Let's start with MTX, which stands for Multi-Tenancy, Feature Toggles, and Extensibility, three key topic areas for when you're building software as a service, SaaS solutions, with CAP. To accompany the recently streamlined multi-tenancy guide, there's now a new guide for extending SaaS applications and solutions, and it relates to the MTX services in the @SAP/CDS MTXS package. Also in this September release are some new features for the CDS language and compiler area, mostly related to improvements to types. And there are important changes to both the Node.js and Java flavors of CAP, including a new beta feature for Redis-based messaging in Node.js and improvements to Postgres in the Java flavor. Check out these new features and improvements and lots more at the usual place, cap.cloud.sap. While event-driven architecture has existed as a concept for a long time, the use of event meshes within organizations is a relatively new phenomenon, but it's certainly growing rapidly as customers understand the benefits of this approach. As the use of such mesh systems increases, there's a need to share events across organizational and also across company boundaries. In the particular case of bringing event meshes together between SAP and Microsoft systems and platforms, there's a new event bridge to link SAP Event Mesh to Microsoft's Azure Event Grid. This new connector allows for a better symbiosis between SAP and Microsoft business applications through event-driven coupling. If you're a developer, an architect, or a basis person, this is something you definitely want to be interested in. And as luck would have it, there's a new SAP beta program where you can get involved, try it out, and give feedback. Read all about this new beta program for the bridge in the post from Carsten.
Hi, everyone. Easy UI5 is an open source tool that lets you scaffold UI5 applications and libraries in no time. And since UI5 now supports TypeScript, Easy UI5 has also been updated with generators for TypeScript. And just recently, a new UI5 library generator has been added to Easy UI5 that will kickstart your UI5 library and custom control development in TypeScript. Check out Wouter's blog post to learn more about it.